Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to be doing a very quick Q&A on the Mysore Infosys training. And now those of you who don't know what we are talking about, this is the first part of the training, the employee training you get when you join Infosys, and it is usually done in the beautiful city of Mysore, and at times some parts of it will be done in some other cities, but usually it is done in Mysore. So this is completely Mysore based. I had it in Mysore, my seniors had it in Mysore, my juniors had it in Mysore. So it's completely Mysore based itself. So before much ado, let's get started. So the first question is, where is the training? The training is always in Mysore. And at times when there are a little bit of different courses or something that you are going to get, or maybe there is not much space in the campus, you might get your training like in Mangalore, Chennai, or anywhere else, but that is like for a very short period of time. Does not mean you're getting posted over there. That is just for training purpose. Second question, do you get accommodations in the Mysore campus? Oh my god, yes, you get rooms like hotel. You get like one of the best rooms out there you have seen in any 5-star hotels. That good is the room, and you're going to get housekeeping, you're going to get intercom services. You know, every morning the housekeeping is going to get you coffee and tea packets and sugar packets, milk packets and everything, and there is already a hot kettle inside your room. The room has a huge television, flat screen television. You can kick yourself out there. It is centrally AC'd. I mean, it is the best thing you can ever have, and it has beautiful wardrobes and sofa system and everything, so you can sit back, kick back and relax and do whatever you want to do. And by the way, the rooms are usually sharing, as in the boys get the single room, the girls get the sharing room. But in our case, we were so lucky, our batch was so lucky that the girls got single rooms, and I got room number one, and I was so excited about it because mine was the first room, and from my zone the room distribution had changed, and I felt so lucky that I got the single room. Second question, do you get food over there? Of course you get food over there. There are like 8 huge food courts, beautifully constructed food courts. Something is in the shape of like a dome, something is like underground, it's so beautiful. Something is like a terrace food court or something, and you get different outlets, so from South Indian to Chinese to North Indian, all different cuisines are going to be there. There is going to be a full plate, and it is highly subsidized. So when I say highly subsidized, it does not cost you much if you are eating in Infosys every day, from breakfast to snacks to lunch to dinner, everything is there, believe me when I say that. And another thing that I want to say is that they have shops like Subway, Domino's and CCD inside the campus, so you don't need to go. Subway is not there in Mysore, Subway is there in Bangalore, my bad. So it's there inside the campus, you can go and eat. And there are various bakeries also, so if you are a sweet tooth like me who loves cakes and everything, you got plenty of options. Are there any smoking zones in the training? Okay, this is a question that actually came in my mail, and yes, there are smoking zones in Infosys. You are allowed to smoke, you're not allowed to drink. And when I say smoke, you're just allowed to smoke the cigarettes. Use your brains. Okay, do you get any salary or stipend during training? Of course you get salary and or stipend. If you're joining as an intern, your training will be for a couple of months, and you will be getting a little less salary than what we are getting. So there are computer science students who in the last semester join as interns, so they get stipend, whereas we completed our graduation from college and then we joined the Infosys training, so we got a tad bit little bit more than them. But that is part of the thing. In fact, I prefer the internship more because you did it during your 8th semester and you directly joined as an employee, whereas we had to take the training first and then we joined as employee. But yeah, there is salary difference and you get salary. How much? I cannot tell you. So how long is the training for both interns and employees? For interns, the training is around 3.5 months, and for employees like us, the training varies from 4.5 months to 5.5 months. How many students are there in a class? Okay, so in my class there were 64 students, and in some classes there were 110 students. So I have seen that between 60 students to 110 students the class is there. And this is generic, by the way. So the generic classes, as in the first part of the training, you will be having something like 60 students to 110 students. After that, the number may decrease. How many training parts are there? So interestingly, the training is divided in two parts. So the generic part is something that is very general. So everyone is taught the same thing. So a couple of years back, they used to teach the first language as Java. Now they have started teaching as Python. I was taught Python. I was trained in Python. Then we are given a training in database management system, as in your SQL, your databases and everything of that sort. And a little bit of training session is given on software engineering. And then using all your concepts, you have to make a group project. So that is the first part of the training, and that is generic. Now, generic is the part where it takes a lot to go through. At least in my case, it was that. And the second part is the stream training. Now, stream training is where you are given a particular discipline that you need to, you know, excel in. So it's like your major, and this is a general part, and this is your major. So my major was database testing. It was basically DWT, that is data warehouse testing. So I was trained in that. There are a lot of people who are trained in Java. There are some people who are trained in .NET and everything. So if you're an intern, you are probably going to be trained in data analytics, Java or .NET, because you will be playing like a core role of a developer, whereas the other people who come after you, they are going to get a lot more varied roles. So some will go in Apple, some will go in data warehouse testing, some will go in Java testing, some will go in a lot of things, IMS and something like that. So the minute you come, you'll get to know more about it. So yeah, two parts of training. Okay. How many exams are there? So each generic has three exams, and stream training has four exams. And each part of training has project. In our case, we had the project. What is the clearing marks for the exams? So in generic, each exam you need to get 65 marks out of 100, including the theory and the practical, that is hands-on and the theory part of it, not the theory part of it, the manual part of it. So you will be having an MCQ set of questions, and you will be having a hands-on question, and you need to get 65 on 100 out of that, which is not going to be easy. So you really need to study when you come over here. And the thing is that in general, you need to get 65 minimum in each exam, so your overall should be 65. And in stream, it can be 50, but then again, your overall should be 65. So that means in stream training, if you're getting in one exam, you're getting like 51 or something, you're passing, that's all. But overall, as in all the four exams put together, you need to get 65 as your passing mark. And by the way, there is negative marking, in case you're wondering, in the exams, and it is one hell of a thing actually. Okay, how many chances you get for these exams? So if you fail an exam, you get second chance, and if you fail that one, so you get a third chance. But if you fail in that one, you're out of the company. So you get two chances from the main exam to clear an exam. Okay. The next question is, ironically, what happens when you fail an exam? So after failing both your attempts from the main attempt, that is your third attempt, the company puts you outside the gates in a very cordial manner. So yeah, you need to study. The moral is always that. Okay. What happens after your training is completed? So after your generic training is completed, you go on to your stream training, and after your stream training is completed, you get confirmed as an employee over there. Not as in complete confirmation, but you become an employee. So from a colored ID tag, you get the black tags, and that is actually like a cool thing. And when you become an employee, you get into several projects and whatever your location is. So you get, you know, a 2-3 day travel and everything, you get orientations and everything. So you just become a part of a project and start giving out something to the company, actually, in the senses. Okay. Does your salary increases after training and any bonus you get? Yeah, your salary will increase after training. And if you're like a top scorer or something, and if you're getting marks into certain zone, like you're getting something like 82 to 92, 92 and above, you're definitely going to get a bonus. Okay, This is fun. This is a part where I get a lot of questions every day on Quora. And this is, can you choose your location in your training? Like after training completes, can you go from Mysore to any other cities? Yes, you are in Mysore just for your training. To get into Mysore is not that easy, by the way. So no. So what locations you get? You get three location preferences. So you can choose anything from Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, to Chandigarh, Pune, Jaipur, Bhubaneswar, anything you can choose. And people who naturally choose something that is closer to their houses or to the cities they like, or wherever their friends are going, or whatever personal commitments they have, they choose according to that. So I chose Mysore after my training, and after Mysore I got my transfer to Bangalore that day. And it's not necessary that whatever locations you put, as in the three locations you put, say you put Bangalore, Hyderabad and Chennai, you're going to get something in that. No, you're not going to get something in that. If there is a business requirement in Pune or Chandigarh or anywhere else, for example, you'll have to go. There is no but, ifs or anything. Yeah, but you can swap your location, as in you have got Chennai and some other person has got Chandigarh. So you can swap that thing, provided he's ready to do it. And you can do it just in your batch. You cannot, you know, swap it with someone else. Someone has to be from your batch and from your stream. Does your salary... Okay, we have done with that. Can your parents or family visit you? Yes, they can visit you. In fact, they can stay with you, if I'm not wrong. And they can stay during the weekend time. You have to pay a small amount for it, so that's okay. But they can visit this beautiful campus, and the visiting hours are always on Saturday. So you need to make sure that you travel, you know, accordingly. You plan the entire thing in that way. What are the different facilities you get in the campus? Oh my God, this is like a huge question, because you get amazing facilities. You get a multiplex, a four screen multiplex, and the multiplex is so huge that you have not even seen an IMAX of that capacity. So you get a multiplex. Every Saturday there are two new movies, Hindi or any other language. So they try to keep a balance about it. Okay, the light change again. We'll settle. Okay, and you can choose anything from that. And you have gym, you have dance classes, you have yoga classes, you have music classes. You can learn French and German. You have got loads of facilities. There are loads of beautiful places in the campus. It's just a dream if you get Mysore. Trust me when I say that. Okay, so that is it for what was a part of Mysore training session Q&A. Have a really bad throat. And in case if you have any more doubts, you can definitely drop it in your comments. You can mail me. I'll put down my mail ID in case you don't want to put it over here. And I'll answer everything as I promised before. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you want more such videos, then do subscribe to my channel.